Hello, I'm Dr. Carlos Del Rio, and I'm an internist and infectious disease specialist based here in Atlanta, Georgia. Welcome to another episode of ACP Ask Your Internist series, where physicians like me answer your top vaccine questions. There's a lot of confusing information circulating online about vaccines. I'm here to answer your questions and clear up the confusion. After you've been exposed to an antigen through a vaccine, you produce antibodies, you produce memory T cells, and the antibodies over time start decreasing. That is what we call the waning of immunity. When you get a boosting, what you're doing is reminding your immune system about that antigen. You're getting it exposed to that antigen again. It's a little bit like, you know, reminding your muscles about exercising. So when you go to the gym and do weight training, you are in a way getting a boosting on your exercise. And also because of the emergence of the Delta variant, the most important thing we can do to fight variants is to prevent transmission. A virus that is not transmitting is not mutating and therefore is not producing new variants. What we learn is that boosting the response in individuals, you get about a 10-fold decrease in your risk of getting infected and about a 20-fold decrease in the risk of severe disease or hospitalization. And this applies across all age groups. CDC is allowing mix and match. In other words, you can be boosted with whichever vaccine you want after you receive an initial series of another vaccine. I tend to recommend that individuals who receive an mRNA vaccine get boosted with another mRNA vaccine. It doesn't really matter if it's Pfizer or Moderna, it's whatever you find available. So one of the risks that has been identified with the mRNA vaccines is myocarditis and myopericarditis. There is a much higher risk of getting myopericarditis after getting COVID. The risk is probably 16 times higher when you get COVID than when you get the vaccine. Myopericarditis after vaccination is actually a very treatable condition. People recovered quickly and rarely leads to hospitalization, and it has not led to death in any case. You know, unfortunately, there's a lot of misinformation out there about impact of the COVID vaccines in fertility. And there's absolutely no data to support this claim. In fact, there's data that we have accumulated showing that there's absolutely no risk of giving the vaccination during pregnancy, giving the vaccine to lactating women, or giving the vaccine in future fertility of individuals. The one thing we do know is that pregnant women are at much higher risk of getting severe COVID than non-pregnant women. And it's very clear that those planning to become pregnant should get the COVID vaccine as a way to prevent them from getting COVID during their pregnancy. We will be back with more vaccine content, so be sure to like and subscribe and click on the notification bell to receive updates on when the next video will be posted.